All right, welcome back everyone to another late night here on the East Coast. So we're back in Europa. You know what? Actually, I didn't check the recording to see if the quality was okay. Hopefully it was. Yesterday? I don't know. I hadn't done Europa in a very long time on stream, and I've changed a lot of settings since then. Oh well. It's probably only going to bother me, but it'll bother me a lot. So last time we tried Ethiopia, we learned the hard way that diplomacy doesn't, you know, work the way you want it to. Rip. Yeah, the world map actually looks really good in this game, bro. Unfortunately, you can't play like this because you can't tell anything that's going on. Otherwise, I would. It looks so nice. We could try it for a bit, maybe, but it's just, no, you can't. Because, see, the big issue with this is you can't tell these are all the same province except for this tiny little line, so... You know what I mean? Oh, looks so good though. Like, look at this. Just absolutely stunning. But anyway, we tried Ethiopia. We found out diplomacy's not our friend anymore. Things have changed. The allies are no longer as useful as they once were. Vassals are a little bit better than they used to be. And the big thing we learned is Ethiopia is corruption is a crippling mechanic. As well as, like, we didn't really get screwed over by corruption, we got screwed over by something that causes corruption, which is religious unity. Having a low religious unity causes a massive problems for your country. It didn't used to be so bad. Now it's, like, really, really crippling. Like, just insane. Problem is, Ethiopia starts off about 40% Sunni, I think. If we can go ahead and check religious. Yeah, so about 40% of it. Almost 50, actually, because we have one Jewish state there. Yeah, just too much. So anyway, as recommended by, I forget who it was, Robopox, perhaps, something along those lines. We're going to check out Congo, which is pretty cool. They're over here in the southwestern part of Africa. They're kind of cool. They're fetishist, which is... not ideal. The nice thing about playing, say, a Catholic, or a Christian, rather, or, you know, the Muslim, or such factions, is, like, the fetishists are sort of very easy to convert. So, you know, you can do these massive wars on them, and they're weaker, and take all their stuff. Unfortunately, we have the not-so-great religion. We're going to have to work around that. We also have a tribal kingdom, which is not a very good government type. I'll go ahead and show you, you know, an empire here. The big thing is the number of states. Now, we're not going to reach that for a while, but number of states is a huge, 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 huge thing. Also, you'll notice our leader has a lot more average stats, and we start a whole tech level behind the rest of the world. We're 2-2-2, so it's going to take us a very long time to do anything super cool. And also, our military is going to suck. Compared to, you know, again, the rest of the world, we're about on par with the rest of Western Africa. And actually, West Africa, or Central Africa, as it says here, even though this is East Africa over in this part, we actually have 5% higher tech cost. We're at 165 instead of 160. So we're even further behind technology. Can we do it? Maybe. We'll see. There's actually an achievement to own all of Africa as Congo. is that doable? We'll see. It used to be possible. But unfortunately, over the years, and especially in the last 2-3 expansions... Paradox has done everything they can to try and shut down blobbing. They don't like people getting big. It's just not how they want you to go about having fun, I guess. So they made it harder to get big, and they made other stuff more interesting. Unfortunately, people play Europa to get big, and a lot of the achievements require you to get huge. So I'm pretty sure some achievements are literally impossible at this point. We'll see, though. Anyway... go try and do Congo. Now, we don't... These uncolonized areas here, these are wastelands. Some other ones will spawn as time goes on. We'll discover places that can be habitable. But right now, they're just wasteland. But you can colonize these. And how it works for the achievement is if we own every place of Africa that is currently a province, we win. So we don't have to colonize everything. And if somebody starts colonizing something, it won't count until it turns into an actual province. And then they core it, I believe. Still, we're up against some stuff. So we're behind in tech. Again, our leader's not great. He's, you know, a little below average. 333 would be average. But, you know, our religion, the fetishist religion, while being terrible, is actually a decent amount of Africa. So finding allies is not impossible, and also we don't have to worry about converting religions for a good chunk of the weaker parts of Africa. Unfortunately, the strong parts are in fact going to be the Sunni and a tiny bit of Coptic. Ethiopia is probably going to disappear from the map at some point. We'll see if they don't convert to Sunni at some point. So it's going to be tricky. Our big issue here is going to be stopping the Sunnis from pushing down. The Mamluks are going to expand. Yemen's going to expand into this way, probably. Now, up here, we don't have to really worry about West Africa, except Castile and Portugal are, at some point, going to take a trip down here and get into this area. The reason why is, you know, in real life, they did. They came down based around here, and that's how they were able to get into this direction. Portuguara, somehow not related to Portugal. Now, the extra annoying thing is you may notice these teeny tiny little specks. So these tiny bits of land are, in fact, colonizable. These tiny, tiny little islands, and they will count towards our achievement. So if somebody decides to colonize them because they want to get access to the New World, we're going to have to kick them off. You know what I mean? This is our Africa. Stay out. You know, Congo no bongo. We got this. Maybe. We're going to try our best anyway. For now, though, we're going to worry about just our tiny part of Central Africa. And my strategy from here, I'm not really sure. Obviously, I want to secure as much of this as I can. I want to get my technology up so I can get access to exploration, so we can find the rest of Africa. Because right now, it's we don't have any idea it's there. And then somehow hold the Spaniards off. I'm not sure we're going to be ready. Now, I was told, I'm not sure if you guys remember yesterday, but somebody mentioned in chat that Congo does get a event to convert to Christianity. I believe Catholicism, but I'm not sure. That might be an interesting choice. It might be something we do. However, again, if we pop over to our religious map, all fetishist, religious unity is disgustingly crippling, as we've talked about. It's possible we just stay fetishist if we get big enough by that point. You've been voted off the island. That's right, Argamia. We do actually start with boats as Congo, which is kind of nice. Light ships, we're going to go ahead and tell them to... Can we protect trade? Select mission. Protect trade, yeah. Let's go to our Ivory Coast. Oh, this is the Ivory Coast. I thought that was down here. My bad. So we're on the Ivory Coast. Go ahead and protect trade here. Do some cool tradey stuff. We have a merchant. I don't really have any place for him right now. We haven't found any other centers of trade. Raffle is now officially King Kong. You know what? Actually, funny you mentioned that. Hang on. I got a picture I want to show everybody. I'm totally cool with being King Kong. Where is my... Oh, you. What? Yeah. Check this guy out, everybody. This right here. This is King Kong. This is us. The glorious, the spear-wielding, pinecone head, master of the long sachet. And we will do our beautiful, beautiful conquest. And yes, the Ivory Coast is where Portugal settled in Northwest Africa. That's right. So Portugal, actually, in real life, Portugal kind of dumps on Congo and vassalizes them. I believe that happened somewhere in the 1800s, though. So it was more recent. And Congo is no longer a country, sadly. It's been absorbed by a larger African country, and I can't remember what it is. Abdolia or something like that. It's not ringing any bells off the top of my head. My current world history is not very good. Up to the Second World War I'm in, but... So, missions. Alright. Oh, we start with a vassal. Now, this is our vassal here. The Congolese coast. I actually want that territory. I desperately need the coast. So, incorporate him as a vassal? Will do. No, not that. Nope. Diplo annex. Should be... Oh, annex vassal. So we have to wait 10 years to do it. We need 190 opinion. Alright, not so bad. Again, it's going to take me 10 years to do that, so I'm not going to go ahead and take that as our mission. Improve their opinion of us. Okay, a diplomatic reputation for 10 years would be cool. It's very unlikely we get the prestige. Who's Tayo? Oh, this one province. It's not happening. That's probably going to be one of our first conquests, actually. Unfortunately. Sorry to hear that, Tayo. You're probably screwed. So yeah, none of these missions are good, actually. I'm just going to take this and then cancel a mission. So there's going to be a year we won't have a mission, which sucks. Missions are pretty OP. Not a whole lot we can do about that. We do have a nice treasury going on. Do we have max force limit right now? No, we can have three more guys. What do we currently have? Two cav. I'd feel a lot more comfortable with three cav, but I'm not sure we have the military tech for it. Our combat width is five, so yeah, we could definitely have three cav, and I think I will. They're so expensive, but it just, it really, really does the do. So I want to have a lot more than everybody else. Because I get the bad feeling we're going to get dogpiled. And I want to make sure that we're very comfortable. Let's see if our economy is actually positive. It is, but it's not as much as it says it is. That's alright. So right now, we don't actually need these transport ships, because there's nowhere for us to transport troops to. So we're going to mothball them, actually. So this will act as if their maintenance letter is at zero. So that's what we're going to do. Basically, we're just going to have them rotting in port. Which I think will be just fine. So, where do we go about doing the thing? I would like... some sort of ally. I may eventually make them a vassal. The question is whom? Let's actually go ahead and look at military strength. If I bring up my ledger here. Military. Armies. So these are all the people we know. Let's go ahead and click total. So we are the strongest. Kilwa is number 2. Mutapa number 3. Okay. Kilwa. Wow. Oh, Mutapa's way down here. Yeah, and this is Killua, of course. Well, they're Suni. They're not going to be our friend. Mutapa, though. I'm going to want this land at some point, but unfortunately, they're a bit too far away for me to really look into. Angola, thank you. Oh, the Democratic Republic of Congo. It's still a thing. Oh, okay. Kazembe. Lunda. Lunda's moderately strong. They're actually kind of in a nice place. I kind of like that. All right. Welcome to being my friend. I can't straight vassalize you, can you? No, I have to have a military alliance first. We'll eventually vassalize these guys at some point. Actually, which land do they want? That stuff. That's fine, actually. Let me go ahead and set the land I want. So if we're looking at his, oh, that's annoying. I can't. Oops. Well, I want this land here so I can break off down into that area. So I think. Let's check this, and I think he wants all of Chokwe. Probably wants that one as well. We want Tayo. We're gonna want these guys. We already view them as part of our empire. Do we have claims on them? Oh, we have two vassals. Oh, okay. That's annoying, actually. Not the end of the world, though. How many more diplomatic relations do we have? One. So yeah, let's go ahead and ask Lunda here. We can take all of Yaka as well. I did that. Unfortunately, I think he wants some of Kanji here. He wants these two of it. He wants Chokwe and that one. This one, Chokwe. He wanted those two. So, yeah. Cool. I think you and I can be very good friends, Mr. Lunda, and you got a very nice shield, actually. I quite like it. What is this? What? Minus one diplomatic reputation for being a tribal kingdom. Yeah, that's fair enough. All right, friend. Nice to meet you, as always. So we're gonna need our spy master here. Go ahead and get Tayo as fast as possible. And Cuba. Cuba is a very powerful nation as well, I believe. For Africa, their tax bases are pretty good. Yaka, also very nice. Something I want to look into at some point. And again, we can't annex our vassals for a while, so we're not going to be worrying about that. Let's go ahead and build. It might make more sense to take Yaka and then Cuba, as Yaka is going to be smaller. But I kind of like to take the bigger guys out of the way early. Now, the nice thing is, if we go for Cuba, Lunda wants in. So we'll do it that way. Unfortunately, he wants this place, which is a very high tax base. But it's actually the production there. It's really good. Oh, they're making chilies. Cuba, home of Cuban cigars. That's right, man. All right, let's try it out. See what happens. So we're not going to be going to war for several months. So I'm actually going to kill my army maintenance to about here. So we'll be making some more money while we wait. And when we are ready for war, we'll be good. So this guy's free. At this point, we really just want to be. Royal marriage would be good. Can't send someone for a couple days, though. You can only interact with someone diplomatically once a month. even though your diplomat returns before then, depending on how close you are. Okay, so we got our diplomatic marriage. We're up to plus 100. Nice. So they quite like us. Some people are getting military alliances. We'll check those out shortly. Right now it doesn't really matter. We have to get their relation up so we can go ahead and ask them to be our vassal. Which is going to be extremely important for me. Oh, we forgot to set rivals. Oh, shit. No possible rivals. Ah, because everyone's too weak compared to us. So, oh, peasants. They could, I mean, you can definitely take on Congo at this point. But apparently the AI doesn't think they can, and I'm fine with that. Totally okay with them being terrified of me. So once we have 10, we'll be able to go ahead and start fabricating claims. And once we get one claim on each, we're going to start the wars going. I think we'll start the Cuban War first. Because again, nobody else is able to get to this guy. So that'll be fine. Might even be worth... It's one of those things. It might be worth giving this to our ally, but... I don't think we will, because... It's only a one province, so doing a claim on it isn't too hard. We may, though. Alright, excellent. So, Cuba here. Fabricate claim on Nunu. Check. Go ahead and fabricate our claim here. Check. And the Tayo one we're going to send home. Yep. So, now we're actually going to... start preparing for war. We've made our money. We're going to jack our army maintenance all the way back up, which is going to hurt a little bit. We didn't check our air, actually. How good is our air? Whoa! All right, one administrative's pretty, like, crappy, but six diplomatic. Man, like, that's not bad. I almost want to take them. We're going to go ahead and actually focus on administrative, which basically takes one from each of these and puts them into administrative, because we need to get administrative tech 5 ASAP, which is our first great idea, or our national idea, or whatever. Six diplomacy, he can convince the sun to go out in the deepest parts of Africa. The sun is in hiding. And only Nzinga Nkua Lukeni can... It sounded like I was speaking Cthulhu there. You know what I mean? That was a little scary, actually. Thought, what was that guy's name? Nakaramus or whatever? Whatever. Pretty cool guy. So, we can send our diplomat somewhere. Where do we want to have claims? Ndongo? Yeah, absolutely. No, wait. This is our vassal. I was like, these assholes! We have to wipe them off the map. No, we need them. So, Yaka it is. Narakimus. Yeah, that was it, yeah. Royal marriage offer from Luengo. I mean, you are my vassal, so I guess we can be friends. We'll start making our... Actually, the supply limit there is not amazing. Sad days. Yeah, we'll head over to Mapungu. Thankfully, no swamps. A lot of grasslands, highlands. That's a jungle, which if we get to first, will give us a bit of a advantage. Is our morale max for his army? Yes. What? 2.06 out of maximum 2.05. I don't, but I'm fine with it. Anyway. We can probably stop our spy network here as well. Yeah. Okay, so the war is going to happen soon. We will arrive on the 15th of November, or November, rather. And remember, it's a good date, so. Let's go ahead and declare war. So they have a lot of allies right now. They have Luba. Who else do they have? Kasanji and Kikonda. Nope. So these guys here. And some random people. I'm not sure. Kasanji, Luba, and Kikonda. Oh, these people, and Kasanji. I don't even know who that is. Maybe I'm blind. Oh, these guys. Oh, that's frustrating. All right, so they're going to have a decent force. Of course they are. Cthulhu speak is too strong, yes. Well, that's it. Officially, we are no longer fetishists. Screw Catholicism. We worship Cthulhu and the great old gods, which I suppose fetishists actually do, but you know what I mean. So if we promise this guy, so he'll join. So the question is, can I take on you, and you? You have 6,000 troops. You have questionable amount of troops. Probably not that many, though. I'd say about 4,000. Let's go ahead and check. So, Kikonja, 6,000. Kasanji, 6,000. Wow, both 6,000 troops. That is crazy. They don't have a lot of territory. And how much does Kuba have right now? Only 6,000. Combined, we have more, but you know what I mean. Well, let's go ahead and see. Let's make a general out of our ruler. A little bit risky. This guy's not, like, super amazing, but... Oh, he's actually not very good, actually. It's not what I needed. I'm gonna have to hire a general here. Unfortunately. What do we get? That's fine. I'll take that. Sort of a annoying waste of monarch points. Let's check if we can actually abuse the estates today. Yeah, we can. Okay, excellent. That'll be fine with me. So, yep. They don't have enough influence, sadly, for us to demand diplomatic power. We're going to need that. And demand military support. It's fine, the nobles won't like me as much, but I think I can... Yeah, lose some prestige, give them a little bit of loyalty. Alright, well, that military power came back, which is excellent. I think we'd do it. The alternative is, who are you allied with? Lunda... Or Luba, yeah? No, Lunda. This guy. Well, he's my ally. And Kikonda. This I like. Okay. If we wait a bit, we could declare on Yaka. Lunda... Well, hang on. Say I declare war right now. I know I don't... Take Yaka. It's a war goal that we can use. Nidongan war goal. What the? Oh, I could take it from my vassal. Okay. And Lunda wouldn't come in, but he would defend. Huh. What a dick. We're bros. Alright, we're not going to do it that way. We'll start this war. We should be able to win. It might actually be smarter for me to come in, wipe out their army, meet up with my ally... That might be a smart way to do it. Incorporate Loango in our country. Yeah, eventually. It's going to take me a long time to do it, though. Let's get rid of the prestige mission, see if there's a better one for us. As long as he comes up to me, if I click friendlies can attach, I think he might try to. And these guys only have one cav. We should be okay. We should be good. Presuming that they don't get much better leaders than we do, which is always possible. So yeah, I will give you Munene if you come into the war, good sir. Please. Oh, I forgot I have vassals. We're fine, everybody. Our vassals have allies. Not very good allies, and hopefully they... Oh, okay. Well, our allies are about to get their asses kicked. Our vassals, rather. That's okay. So there's no fort level here, so we should be able to take it and start the war score ticking right away. At that point, we just need to crush their armies and pray. If both my vassals meet up, they might have a chance of stopping this guy. He is an okay leader, so it's very unlikely. And they have a fort here in Kuba. We're assaulting across a river, but we have twice as many guys, so... I feel pretty good about it. I feel pretty good. I would really like my ally Lunda here. Did he not join the war? No. Huh. Okay. I thought I promised him some stuff. Oh, I could have called to arms him. Maybe I save it? We don't need him for this conflict. So, I think we'll just hang on to him. But yeah, we take a river crossing penalty in the terrain. But our leader is better at shock. Oh no. Wow, his leader is so good. Jeez, I wish I had him. But I don't, so. That's alright. Not the end of the world. Very easy expansion to Kuba here. It's going to take them a while to siege his fort, which I'm fine with. Because again, that's not part of the war score anyway. Or like the war goal, so. We're going to keep our diplomat free because we're going to be very shortly ending this war. Declaring a little bit of peace. So Lunda's not going to be happy if I take this. But that's okay because we're going to be declaring other wars where he can get things. And the nice thing about this is because... Yeah, so we just wreck that guy. We've lost a lot of troops, sadly. Can't detach a siege. There we go. Get the siege going. Go ahead and create a new unit. Just take two spearmen. Send them in this direction and send the main force to Kuba to siege it up. The nice thing is actually, so Kasanje and like all these people here in Luba, They're all now going to be at peace with me. Or at least there will be a truce. You know what I mean? So the cool thing about that is I'm going to be able to start some cheeky wars later on. Well, there goes our one vassal getting his teeth kicked in. But that's okay. But I'm going to be able to start some cheeky wars later on. And they're not going to like be able to do anything about it. Hopefully he just runs away. Okay, excellent. We're going to have to run down here and take this guy on. You know what, actually? Yeah, we can sue for peace with, yeah, we could sue for peace individually with people. I'm tempted to call our ally in. And if he kills this guy, we'll give him some territory. If we promise him land, he'll come in. Alright, we might be able to do a bit of an extremely aggressive land grab here. So let's call him in and see what happens. So if he comes in and kills this stack for us... sieges these down. Because I forget, does he want that land? Yeah, he wants those too. And I will happily give him those. They're actually pretty decent provinces, truth be told. But that's fine. I might even just give him this piece. We'll see. Only time will tell. Let's go ahead and make our way here. So this guy should... Friendlies can attach this, please. Now we should really have our leader here on this group. But I didn't do that just in case of this right here. Massive enemy force. We'll see what happens. They have two pretty good leaders, actually. If we could win the siege sometime soon, that'd be cool. So, once our men get here... No, not that way, you fools! Everybody come with me! Now, we're going Cassandre first. Alright, well, I would rather assault these guys, but okay. Can we not siege that? Can we do the useful stuff? Are they all coming now? There we go. So now we've grabbed everyone. We got a pretty decent stack here. We should be able to wipe these guys, even though we do have the river crossing penalty. This is our ally's land anyway. We're not too worried about him losing his stuff. At least I'm not, because I'm a terrible, terrible person. I'm going to go ahead and tell my spy to fabricate a claim here on Yakka. Yep. So this guy's getting crushed. Now, from this point, our vassal's actually rebuilding his forces, which is awesome. Wow. Must have got some really good rolls there. That's a bit crazy. So from this point, once we take Kubo, we could actually run down here, if we wanted, and sandwich his army. Yakka's declared war on Cassandre. Oh, I'd rather you didn't, son. I'd rather you not take this land, Yakka. Now, I mean, it's smart of him to do this, to attack him while he's getting dogpiled. Unfortunately, it means Yakka's forcing my hand. Actually, yeah, Yakka's forcing my hand, unfortunately. So they're going to go ahead and retreat. Retreat for 10 years. Where are you going? Okay, I don't think you should fight this, to be honest. Alright, well, I guess he's going in. Can't stop the damn fool. Oh, no, stay here. Shit. So, annoyingly, we can't stop our guys from leaving us, so Yakka's gonna take all this territory. A very, very simple snatch and grab. We're gonna get a pretty good flank on this guy, though, so. Well, that was a little buggy. Oh, it looks like our allies actually went over there instead of for the big fight. So we're gonna lose this unless he immediately comes up to help the war effort. Yeah, he is. Okay. Might be too late by then. We'll see. Because we don't have a lot of morale tech right now in Africa. So, yeah. Okay, well, it's a little late. Oh, well. Merchants worried about lack of protection. With our focus on free trade, our merchants are concerned that are not getting support. Well, they would under a more mercantilist policy. So we can lower our trade range and trade efficiency. Or gain some mercantilism. Mercantilism is pretty strong for trade purposes, which we're not. We don't have anything near that yet, but that's okay, actually. I'll take a little bit of mercantilism now. Thankfully, our allies decided, hey, You know what? Killing all the enemies is probably a good idea. Thank frickaroo. Unfortunately. Where are they going? Yeah, probably up here. Unfortunately, we're not going to be able to get this guy. Which is really sad. Yaka's going to take all of this. Now, the good thing is, if Yaka takes all of this... I've got some prestige. Few are the countries in the world who do not claim to value honor and justice, but even fewer are the countries who live up to these ideals. However, the lack of large-scale and everyday corruption in Congo has made it one of the rare places where principles matter over personal gain. Wow, even abroad, Congolese expatriates are sought after for positions of trust, as our people are known for adherence to duty and rejecting attempted bribes. Who else can claim to live up to these ideals? Well, not many, that's for damn sure. Oh, nice. Is this guy even in the war, or are they just also fighting, or... I guess they were also at war. Oh, in the Luba we go. Kazembe and Luba seem to be at war. I'm not really sure what's going on. Either way. I would love... Luba, though. I'm gonna be a little bit cheeky here and try and do a snatch and grab of... No! Don't you dare! That's too late. They're sieging that province. Alright, down here we go. So, wow, Africa got crazy right now. But anyway, the nice thing is, so Yaka, we're not gonna have a truce against. Who are his allies? Kakanja, which we are going to have a truce against. So he won't be able to join in the war. I mean, this guy's going to be losing territory shortly. But the nice thing is, if Yaka gets bigger, we still get to go to war with them. And, oh, shit. Somebody help that man! Or don't help him. I don't know. Okay, I helped him. But yeah, we might be able to, like, what's going on? War, huh? What is it good for? It's good for money, profit, and territory, my friend. But we're going to be able to call Lunda in to that war as well, because he wants some of this territory. You know. And that's a good thing. It's a very, very good thing. We're going to do some cheeky stuff. Okay, excellent. We're not worrying about peace offers, thank you. We don't take peace from damn dirty traders. So what we are going to do, though, is a... No, I know it was a song borrowed, but you should know this by now. I'm a bit of a fan of... reading song lyrics, if you will. I think that's funny. So I think right now the siege is Lunda. So we have nothing to be gained by helping that, unfortunately. We're going to be declaring war on this sucker soon, though. Speaking of... Can't fabricate a claim on this yet, but we soon will once we take over these provinces. We've lost a lot of troops, though. Like, a lot of troops. It will take almost our entire manpower to reinforce. It's a bit awkward. But it's okay. So I'm waiting for this guy to win his siege. Did Lunda want any of this territory, actually? No, he doesn't want any of these. So he'll be okay with me taking them, presumably. As long as I give him this one. Less troops means less upkeep, that's true, yeah. And less mouths of fees. Yeah, that's why our treasury is doing so well right now. Absolutely. Man, Africa is just a crazy hotbed, and I'm loving it. Okay, new mission, vassalized Teo. Again, that's not gonna happen. Oh, I mean, that's interesting. Subjugation. Cassius Belli is pretty cool. But not happening. Once again, useless missions. Oh well. Okay, so you, Kikonja, how are you, good sir? I'm gonna sue you, just you, for peace. I cannot make it a core. So. I could force him to be a vassal. That's an interesting idea. I'm not sure I'm in love with that, though. We'll hold off on you. So, Luba, I'm gonna have the same problem. Kasanji, we can't take any of your stuff. Right? Military access from Tayo. No, that's fine, pal. So, what can I? I can't demand any provinces from you. Since it's occupied by another enemy, yeah. I could force you to be my vassal, though. Which is tempting. Because this is a lot closer, but we are going to war with Yaka. So that'll be fine. I can just... How much money can I take from you? 51. And I can force you to pay me war reparations. No, you won't take that, huh? Need at least 10 war score to make demands. Oh, right, because we never actually took any of his stuff. We just killed all his guys. Fair, fair. So what do we do here? I can't take any of your provinces, sadly. Lunda doesn't want them, so I can't give them to him. And you're just like a little... You kind of look like a little turd, actually. There has to be some way. Some way to do this. Can't vassalize these guys for another 7 years. I don't really want to lose 7 years of Diplo power. Oh, yeah. Battleborn launched last night. Oh, that happened, yeah. Potentially, I could break alliance with Lunda. What do I suffer for doing that? Probably bad things. Maybe we just take a lot of money from this guy. 54. Make him pay us war reparations. That could be good. Make him give up claims and everything. Sure. I think that could probably be fine. We'll be back for you in many years, my friend. Sure. I mean, the money's nice, honestly. It's very hard to get money at this point. So, we need to get Luba out of this. I'm really annoyed that I can't get anything from Luba, really. I'm not sure why The war score is so low. Okay, I can ask for these. We're gonna take Luba. I'm gonna make them pay me a lot of money, because we're not gonna be able to fight them for a long time anyway. And then I'll divvy up these provinces. These guys are already out of the war. Yaka only took one province, which is interesting and very, very good for us. Perfect. Okay. So, hello there. So, are we still at war with these guys? Yeah, we are. So now Lunda's over there. Okay, I don't really know what happened, but apparently Luba's bugged now. Okay, sure. Also, our manpower has been dying for some reason. I don't really know what's been going on in this province, but it hasn't been good. Anyway, how do I give this one to our ally? Ah, okay. Oh, I see. That's really cool. Alright. So, Lunda we give to him, right? Did I do that right? No, I don't. I won't want that. I want to give it to. How do I give this to my ally? Like. Lunda will gain 9 power projection. Did I do that right? Demand their full annexation. Send demand. But they won't do it. What the fiddly fuck? I don't know. Man, okay, game got really confusing again. Also, again, my entire army's like dead for absolutely no reason. Just because they were over here. With a totally fine supply limit. Oh well. Now decline. I have no idea what's going on, to be honest. So we have to go back to our territories so we can come siege this. Are we at war? With Luba still? Yeah, we are. Okay. Fine. I mean, whatever. Just how it be, I guess. So what are you giving me now? I mean, if we just wait, eventually it's gonna... Like, we're gonna win it. Our vassals sieging that, which is excellent. Oh, I can't get to them anymore. Let's just sit here, boys, honestly. God knows what's happening at this point. We'll just win eventually. That's how time works. No. Okay, so maybe I can just tell Luba to just get the fuck out of the war because he's an idiot. Sadly, I don't have any war score for absolutely no reason. Okay. Also, the other annoying thing. So, I sieged this province, and they demanded it in war, which, it's not really how that should work, because we just saw that you can't demand a province, but anyway, whatever. Game is buggy as shit right now, apparently. And we don't have enough manpower to reinforce, and we'll just sit and wait for this to get sieged. Peace out with these guys. I'll just wait then. Oh, new mission, finally. Improve relations with Yakka, blah blah blah. Like, literally none of this is gonna happen ever. Sure, let's go for improve our prestige, I guess. We'll cancel it at some point. Perfect. Okay, now we got our 99. Oh boy, alright. Yeah, that, and also... Yeah, Lunda, I'm literally trying to give you... Here, you can have Cassandra there. Oh, I guess you had to siege it yourself. Oh, okay. Interesting. Done. Fine. Happy days. Take... Oh, how much money? Ally Lunda here. A little bit of a... Kind of a whale, I guess. We've expanded. Yakka is asking for trouble. Apparently we have a truce with them. No, with Tayo. How do you get a truce with Tayo? How did that even happen? I don't know. But now we can fabricate claims on things and stuff, and that's excellent. We don't actually need you there anymore. Apparently we have a truce with them. No, with Tayo. How do you get a truce with Tayo? How did that even happen? I don't know. But now we can fabricate claims on things and stuff, and that's excellent. We don't actually need you there anymore, my friend, I'm afraid. As much as I would love you to stay. So, we need work on here, and we need claims on... Oh, this guy. I mean, we can go to war right away with this guy, right? Yeah. I mean, he doesn't really stand a chance, to be honest. So, some of your provinces lack cores. Doesn't really cost us anything, so we'll do that. I mean, we're all the same religion, right? Yep. Done dealio. Unfortunately, this is going to nuke our administrative power. How much do we need? 979. Oh my goodness. It's just so expensive to tech up a Central Africa. Oh, jeez. Well, alright. Not going to be able to do that anytime soon, so let's go ahead and... Yes, core, 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 and core. Yeah, that's fine. We might actually boost our stability at this point. We don't really need it. It'd be a little bit more money. Now we're going to save the administrative points because we don't have a whole lot of those, sadly. So we will declare war against you. I know, you're not going to happen. Oh, we could take it for our ally. Or our vassal, rather. It still cost us stuff, though, so... Might as well just take it for ourselves. Real marriage from Ndongo. Yeah. Hello, little friend. We are much bigger than you. Come visit. Yeah, bad news bears for you, I'm afraid. So Lunda wants this province. I've got claims on these. We'll be declaring war on Yakka very shortly for them. I'm a terrible person, and also I don't really care. Would I be able to offer vassalization to you, my friend? No, I'm apparently not economically more powerful than you. Just you wait, good sir. Or not enough, anyway. Not enough. Whoa! Am I reading that right? Oh my frick. Like, previous monthly balance was plus 56.21, but that was because we demanded a lot in a war. I was almost like, what? Where are you retreating to? Nagoya. Yeah, whatever. I'm just going to sit here and siege your province, to be quite honest. Oh, our ally was ready. And, oh, no way does he lose this. Really? He might actually, because... Like, our vassal, rather. Because he has only cavalry, which you're really not supposed to do. Yeah. I mean, they had zero morale, and they just got shit on. Good job. You're really helping in the war effort there. Would you like to pop over and... Alright, we're going to split this stack in half. Apparently my vassals are a little bit of the dumb. So we'll, You want to come in with me, guys? No? Shit. Alright. Have to reinforce with the horse. Yeah, we're probably gonna lose this because we left all our infantry behind. Oh, jeez. No, like... You damn fool. Oh, we could have stayed after all. Eh, it's fine. Make it safe. So what do we got here? High taxes, blah, blah, blah. We could get more unrest. Yeah, I'm fine with some unrest. Well, Ndongo's my vassal, so if he captures that, I mean, it works out for me. Where are you guys headed? Soyo. War exhaustion is high. That's fine. Actually, let's just head over here. Oh, video games. Why you gotta be so difficult? I really like having this, though. It's just a fun little province there. It's just gonna take so long to reinforce our manpower reserves. But that's okay. We might be able to afford a cheap advisor. Missionary strength. I'm tempted to pick that guy up early. But we don't need it now, so it's like, you know. I hope he stays there for a long time, though. Don't need any of this stuff here. Discipline. Reinforced speed is cool, but discipline, I think. But again, I don't really need more military power points. They're good, but I don't really need them. You know. It's going to be a while till we're able to take this guy on. It's because I have to wait for my men to reinforce. It's going to take... What, 40 months? Jeez. 40 months to recover. Alright. That's good. So we're maxed relations now with you. Go ahead and recall our diplomat. I believe we can get a little bit more if we offer military access, yeah. It's pretty good. We have a claim on one of their provinces, so they like us a little less. I wonder if I could give that up. Wouldn't mind. Alright, there. And why would you not vassal with me? Okay, because we need to be more powerful. That's fine. Some point, my friend. Hello. Full annexation, absolutely. A little bit of overextension. Meh. I don't care. And we'll go ahead and make it a cool 64 because of our war exhaustion. I don't know about that. We could wait for our war exhaustion to go down, which it will eventually do in a very long time. Corruption's getting to be a bit of a thing because of overextension, but that'll go down as we core things. Yeah, war exhaustion is a little high, I suppose. There's recruitment time, shipbuilding time, no national unrest. Alright, you talked me into it. We won't immediately jump into another war. We'll wait. I want to, but, you know. Can't afford one of those. So, since we're not going to war with anyone for a little bit, again, we're going to drop our army maintenance all the way down here. That's good. And just get the cash flows going. Just nice and relaxing music. wonder if Lunda's thinking about going to war soon. I don't know. What year can we start vassalizing you, actually? Okay, in 5 years. Huh. It's 130 and still 23 degrees in your room? Ouch. It's gross. Fortunately, summer is finally starting to hit, so yeah. I was hoping we could avoid it forever. No dice. Oh, what is happening here? Okay, core province is cool, but what is happening here? Why are you guys doing the big war? Kalundwe, it looks like, is fighting. Whoa, there's a big war going on. Yaka allied with Kakonja, who is allied with Luba and Yaka. So Luba, Yaka, and Kakonja are fighting Kalundwe right now, it seems like. Yeah. Oh, really? Oh! I want to go fight them! I want to take Songye. That would be a wonderful addition to my provinces. Yeah, it'd be pretty good. Alright, well, that's fine. Our war exhaustion's slowly going down. Excellent. Overextension's gone down a lot. Which is nice. Very nice. States demand control of provinces. You a little upset about that? A little upset you don't have any provinces? So who wants one? The clergy. Well, I guess I could give you something. Let's see, what is kind of useless? Nunu, it's not very good. Gotta be said, this is actually pretty awful. Alright. Go ahead and clergy that for me. Good job. Oh, they need a little bit more land. Alright. Kuba. Was also not a maze, actually. 3 military. Wow, really? Something I would give off to, well, it's a territorial core right now. Shitty. That one's decent. This one's terrible. Go ahead and give that to the clergy. There you go. Now they're happy. Okay. Can you guys, we get 2,000 manpower by clicking this button, just lower their loyalty a little. It's tempting. Disasters page, pitchfork, a farmer's gone mad, they're impaling everyone! Yeah, that'd be funny, eh? Gives us a good general of 40 tradition. Huh. That is cool, but gives them more influence. There's already pretty high, actually. Yeah, unfortunately, I don't have a good way of. And this is what I really want to do, demand military support, so. We're gonna wait for war exhaustion to go down a little bit. Eh, what the heck. It's not the end of the world. Wow, I'm glad I didn't jump on that. That's a huge fight. Who won? Yeah, Yaka and everyone. I mean, they're ripe for the picking. If I went to war now, would you join? No. Because you have a truce. Do I have a truce? No way, do I have a truce with these guys? I guess they had another war with Lunda at some point. Until when? When does this truce end? 3 years. Ugh, this conflict's gonna be over in that time. These guys' army have been beat, though. I mean, even with no maintenance army, like, literally zero morale, actually, by the time I get over there, we could probably jack up our maintenance and see what happens. I think that could be fun, because I don't have a truce with these guys. And all I need to do is just a quick little grab of Songye. Just edge my way ever closer to here, because ultimately this is what we want. We want to get in this area here, get the lakes, and start making our way up and then down. Because we really want to start getting over here. Alright. So all these people would help. Kazembe, Chokwe, and Lunda. Lunda would help, really? Lunda, you're my ally, dick. Alright, well, never mind then. False alarm. Well, actually. Now, he wouldn't join us in this war with Yaka. But Kanja wouldn't either. I mean, this is tempting. Okay. Which is their better province? Yaka. Yaka's really good. Alright. Let's do it. Let's do it. Did I already kill the funding? No, I haven't. Okay, excellent. This is a bit of a gamble. You guys know I'm a gambler. You guys know I'm crazy. Eh. Whatever. See what happens, boys. Some of these people. So Kakanja did actually join the war. No, no, that's right. That's only Yaka stack right there. Okay. Let's go ahead and quickly grab this. Build a great palace. Monarchs were often struggling with ways to subdue the nobility. The rise of firearms reduced the nobles' role as warriors, but left them with, in the eyes of the monarchs, too much idle time. Some monarchs created great new palaces with elaborate court rituals to dazzle the nobles and keep them occupied. Versailles is the greatest expression of this movement. So we could gain prestige and legitimacy, but lose money. I'm gonna do that, yeah, because prestige is pretty cool. It's pretty cool. That's Yaka's army. I'm fine with that, pal. See what happens. See what happens when I grab my vassals and come stomp your face. I'll let you know. Okay, so we're suffering massive attrition here. That's what's happening. They will arrive in Nunu on the 6th. That's a river crossing. Yeah, we'll leave our allies actually behind. And that'll be fine. So our allies can siege this, and if they need help. Who's leading the siege now? Please tell me my allies didn't somehow stop. Okay. My ally is still the siege going. Would have been pissed. Oh no, not the Spaniards borrowed. Okay, so these guys are pissing off. Kanja's still here. I kind of want to stop him from sieging back his own province, but I can't. That's okay. And I don't have to, because he's going to leave this. Is there a siege going on here? No? Okay, good. And now he's screwed. He can try and attack, but if he attacks, I'm going to easily crush him. So yeah, we're going to annex Yaka. That's going to be great. Rebel Uprising. Oh, Kuban Separatists. Ah. So yeah, they're sneaking in down this way. March 25th. I can't really stop that. That's okay. So, Cuban separatists, huh? Yeah, they have fairly high unrest here. We could lower that by giving them the clergy, although these lands are actually kind of decent, so I'm not going to. We could increase autonomy. It's already pretty high, and it's not giving us much of anything because it's so high. Or we could use harsh treatment on them. Boost stability. Yeah, actually, that's not a bad idea. I probably should have boosted stability earlier, but I really want to save up our administrative power, but yeah. And that is going to help a little bit. So, when does it look like they'll happen? Yeah, once we get Yakka itself, we've effectively won the war. So we just need to keep an eye on these guys here. So our war exhaustion being high is starting to affect us. Yeah, I can understand that. Understand that a little bit. That's okay. All right, yeah, that didn't help. We'll spend 50 military points to reduce it, yeah, because I don't really want to worry about these guys while I'm in a war. It's unfortunate, but you know, gotta keep the rebels down, even if it means, you know, sending in the troops and kicking their teeth in a little bit. Right, thanks for moving in here, Kakanja, and killing off my guys. I really appreciate that. Alright, excellent. So he's going to move back to here. And once he does, we're just going to move down here ourselves and re-siege it. Because why not? And then he's going to have to run all the way around here to get to here. And hopefully by that point, this will be done. Okay, so Lunda, alright, you already like us. We're going to start improving relations right now with this guy. Because, again, we are going to want to, in about 4 years' time, vassalize him, or 3 years. So we need him to like us by then. And Vandal, sorry, he's already our vassal. We want to annex him and make him a part of our nation. Okay, Defender's Desert. Excellent. We're gonna move up here and just be a jerk. He's like, oh, I made it here. Oh, now I gotta walk all the way back around. Yeah, it's gonna happen. Okay, Rebel Uprising. Yeah, we'll worry about that later. Alright, Kalundwe. Who are you? No, I don't like you. Let's go ahead and just do the annex thing. It's beautiful, get some money out of it. What else can we do? Release nations? Cassandra? No. Oops. Well, they no longer exist after the war. That's true, yeah. It will be gone. Done. Alright. Remember when I said we were gonna have peace, everybody? Now we're gonna have peace. Right now. Happening. Oh my goodness, like 83 to core Yakka itself. Gotta do it, unfortunately. Brutal. Absolutely brutal. It's so hard playing these underdeveloped nations. Okay, so Yakan Separatists. Stop. Everybody, march with me this way. Y'all coming? Nobody's coming. Okay, thank you. Thank you. Just leave me alone. Go attack somebody else. States demand control of your provinces. The clergy again, these guys. Do we have any I was going to say, this is already clergy stuff. Low development. This we can't because it's a territory. This we could, but I like that one, so... We can put him here and just lower unrest in the Kuban area. Sure. I mean, might as well, I guess. They will get us a little bit of tax, which will be nice. National decisions, huh? Encourage divination. National unrest, but increases stability cost for the rest of the game. Yeah, I'll take that, actually. Lower unrest is cool. So, where... These guys have already happened, but they're... Okay. I don't know if they're actually trying to attack me or not. No idea what's going on with them. Oh, fuck. Our spy that was in Kalundwe just got caught. Thankfully, we still have the spy network points. It's okay. Go ahead and get that going. I think we're still too big to have any rivals. Yeah. Alright, so yeah, they are, in fact, trying to fight me. Don't really have the men for it, but I can buy a few mercenaries. They're a little expensive, yeah, but... I'm going to have to put down a few rebellions in a short amount of time, so I'd rather not spend the manpower doing it. I think that's what we do. And my vassals aren't interested in helping me, sadly. So, we got to do it this way. We'll wait for all these guys to show up. Okay. There we go. When do you arrive? November 4? November 6? Okay, you guys start heading. What time do you arrive? 9 and 4. Shit, really? Okay, you guys should arrive on time now. Yep. That'll be fine. Holy fucking hell. Wow, could you roll any higher? Just randomly. Okay, wow, that was absolutely terrifying. Jeez. There goes most of my army for the next thousands of years. And then our vassals, of course. Our vassals are really dumb, and I don't know why they're so dumb. They just jump into, like, death stacks of enemies. Like, yeah, we'll totally take them on. Don't worry about it. What? They, like, massively outnumber us? Yeah, who cares? Yeah, can you come with me, maybe? That'd be great. I could really do with that. Alright, we good? No? You wanna walk all the way up here for no reason? Alright. Now you're coming? Are you coming? I don't know. Jeez, these guys are dumb. Alright. Okay, are you coming back now, or what's going on? I don't know. I have no idea what these vassals are doing. But yeah, they heard a little bit of rustle in the bushes. You got that right, Origami. Alright. Let's get a decent mercenary army going, I guess. Because our vassal has no interest in helping with our rebellion. Which, I guess, do what you gotta do. Alright, boys, everybody meet up. We have like a billion more people than they do. just walk in, and that should be... Are they assaulting me? Oh, they are. Okay, so we have the defensive. We have almost three times as many people. I'm going to be a little annoyed if this doesn't... Okay, it did. Okay, rebels put down. Excellent. We're still going to be losing a lot of money for a little bit. Because I've got to re-siege these, and then I have to pull even more guys out of my ass to put down these rebels. Is that super fun and exciting? Yeah, well, nothing I can do about it, sadly. And more rebellion down here. That's actually a very small stack. I should be able to go wipe that out right now. Apparently not. Apparently vastly outnumbering the enemy. Oh, yeah, I know we lost. What the fuck? I don't understand how I'm losing. What is their leader like? Oh, he's amazing. Yeah, well, that happens then. Alright. Man. Video games are pretty cool. Poor iron. Alright, yeah. It's more expensive to recruit guys. Fine and dandy. Alright, come on, everybody. So, unfortunately, recovering from the huge amounts of guys, not impossible, it just sucks. Because even if you win, you... Well, thanks, Linda. Oh, because they spilled over and started attacking your stuff. Like, yeah, I guess I can help my ally. Alright, well... Yeah, I know, we're tanking money. That's okay. We'll be able to repay that at some point. Oh, and Lunda even lost to these guys, apparently. Wow! These rebellions. Don't mess around. Now, I don't know if this counts as a... Oh my god. Ugh. So... They're attacking me. Okay, good. So they have a river crossing. So clergy estate loses loyalty. We gain some money. And they lose some influence. Or we'll find the money elsewhere. Prestige and loyalty. Prestige helps with stuff, which is pretty cool. Yeah, that happens, bro. Interactions. No. So, I can take a... Like, it's pretty much nothing from them. And they lose influence. Which is... Not a terrible thing. I mean, it's not a lot of money. Prestige is okay at this point. And getting loyalty and influence from them is pretty cool. Get some nice bonuses. I mean... We can essentially pay it right back except for the influence loss, which is okay. I think we'll go find the money elsewhere, though. Get some more bonuses to stuff. Okay, I was going to say, there's no way we'd lose this. Like, we had a billion more guys. Alright, really quick. Detach mercenaries. It's majority of my army, that's fine. Run down here, and if we need to take money out of the treasury again, I'll just kill you off. Hopefully you have enough... Okay, are they going to win that for me? They're going to win that for me. Right. Well, we'll use you for the rest of the month. Re-siege our provinces. And sell you off. Rebel uprising. We'll worry about that later. What's the conversion rate for gold ducats to silver crowns? Not bad. We're just going to get rid of these guys. Tyrion. When is that going to happen, actually? The next revolt will be in about 2.2 years. 1.4 years. Yeah, let's just get rid of them. We need to start recouping that money. Okay, we got this back. My poor manpower, though. Shit the bed. But oh well. I mean, we were pretty aggressive. We're going to be doing a lot better when our military power gets up. The problem is, though, is rebellions have higher tech and more powerful troops than you do normally. They're supposed to be on par with you, but if you're playing as one of the weaker nations, if you will, like Africa and stuff like that, yeah, that's not how it works, unfortunately. So, what can you do? So we got 2.4 years for that guy. It's not too bad. We might be able to have a bit of an army by that point and do something about it. Alright, so we're back. The next siege will be in Yaka, it seemed like. We'll be spawning in Kambuna or Yaka. Kambuna, actually, we can increase autonomy here. I think I'm going to. Yeah, it's hard to say. Let's go ahead and look at our states and territories, though. I would like to make this a state. Oh, it's only two. I guess it's not really worth it, then. That's a nice big one. It's fairly big. Alright. This is a okay size one. Yeah, it's only two, so there's not a real value, unfortunately, in making this a proper state. Actually, they're all Kasai. This would be a really nice one if we took over Linda's territory. One of our advisors dies. Jeez. Alright. Oh, shit. I forgot I could lower our army maintenance all the way down. Got our money back. Got our manpower back. Recover some dudes. And 11 years for these guys, yeah. So our national unrest is slowly going down over time, which is good. That divination's really helping out. Overextension, it's going to be gone. War exhaustion on its way out, thankfully. People finally realized, hey, maybe we went a little bit overboard with the war thing. So can we annex you as a vassal? You need 190 opinion. Which we should be able to get shortly. A couple months, maybe. And then, yeah, we can annex these guys diplomatically, which would be cool. What about you? Okay, finally got Kambuna. Improved relation over here. Are you interested in becoming a vassal? Still not yet. You still think you're pretty hot shit, huh? Well, you're not. Not really. You got some nice provinces, but oh well. Oh yeah, we do have to pay back those loans. We should repay those sooner than later. Because the game doesn't automatically repay loans for you. So you have to do that, because you'll find yourself where it's like, oh, the loan is due. And you're like, what? Whoa, that's nice. Oh, crap. Either a ton of money or what I'm going to go for. Of course, trade efficiency isn't really helpful right now. We're not making a lot of trade, but 50 diplomatic power is 5... that's 10 months of power. You know what I mean? That's really good. Oh, we're slowly learning more about the land here. Or the ocean, rather. So it looks like Cambuna is our big place right now. Alright. So we will recall our diplomat. And over here, actually, can recall you from doing that as well. Don't need that. Annex vassal. Perfect. We're going to begin diplomatically annexing them. Just going to sap our diplomatic power. That's okay. We really want more of the coast. So what are you looking at for territory now? You're still not looking to expand anymore in this direction. Really? It's interesting. I'm surprised by that. Well, who's Chokwe allied with? Kazembe and Kalundwe? Yeah, so they're a little bit of a larger force to reckon with. I mean, if we were full strength, we could definitely take them. But it's getting there. It's going to be the trick. If I can demand some... We really need administrative power. Not yet. 10 years. 10 years we'll be able to. And this will be done in 1 year. So it's not too bad. Again, it's costing us our birds every month, but that's okay. So we could lose some loyalty here. But get a crapload of manpower right away. That is actually pretty tempting. We could also get more. We could get more loyalty from giving them some provinces. Which maybe that's worth doing. So this increases local unrest for, like, that's so crazy. But, I mean, the autonomy is so high in these areas, which lowers the amount of manpower and, like, just everything we get from it. So let's lower it there. Like, this place is insane. Over there. Can we lower it anywhere else? Not quite. Yeah, we shouldn't actually have any here, so soya we should lower as well. And the burbs, yeah. Freaking burbs. And if we do it here, I mean, these guys are already thinking about uprising, so. Let's see here. So 14 years, 1.3 years. So the 1.3 years is the only one we really need to worry about. We're gonna have to start reinforcing our armies by that point. Let's go ahead and repay that one loan. Okay. Slowly increase our army maintenance now. Still nowhere near enough to level up our technology yet, though, unfortunately. I'd really like, I mean, getting Diplo tech up, not a huge deal for us right now. But the military tech, like 0.5 more land morale. Like going from what? Well, I think it's about 2, right? 2 land morale to 2.5, it means like, once you reach that, as opposed to your enemy, like, you just crush them. It's disgusting. We should, Diplo annex you guys soon, right? Yeah. Whoa, okay, they rose up way before they were supposed to. That's for damn sure. A little sad. Sad about that. Oh well. We don't want to get too close to them because we're not full strength yet. 10 years of separatism, yeah. Oh well. Yeah, let's just reinforce a little more. Should be able to get it up to 8 something. And I don't really want to fight them right now. Oh, the Yakan are about to rise up as fuck. Yeah, well, that was a. They spawned right on top of us. And we lost, of course. Oh, video games. Why? Like, why, though, for real? I don't ask for much. You know? I could have put those guys down, but. Alright, let's call in some favors, I guess. So, we need the manpower from that. Yeah, it's not happening. Shit. You got a little bit of money here, there's some loyalty. Yep, that's fine. Okay, because we need a shitload of mercenaries again. Alright. So we're going to have to be taking, again, those loans are going to happen. Took us forever to pay them off, but we're going to have to pay them off again. Not much I can do about it, sadly. Let's meet up here. Okay, 10,000. These guys are going to sit here, and I'm fine with that. The Yakan separatists, though, are going to move between these. When a smaller country gives up its independence to join a greater realm, there's a lot of adapting. While some parts are easy, the administration of the realm will still need to expand and accommodate the possibilities. So we lost some diplomatic reputation. That's fine. However, we've now officially annexed all this shit, which which is cool, which means these troops are ours. Thank frickaroo. It also puts us over our force limit, which I can fix in half a second. Done. So now we got some more guys. If we come from here, it shouldn't count as a... Well, I was going to say it shouldn't count as a river crossing. A little late, though. We don't really have a choice. That's fine. If he goes here, then we can come down here. And it, there shouldn't be a river crossing if I'm going from here to here. There's no river between them. And their morale is a bit low. Which is excellent. Yeah, I know. I have loans. Don't worry about that. Okay, again, I have a lot more guys. We should win, but we're not going to. Holy shit. Because I guarantee you... hang on. 2.15. No, we got the same morale. Like, I don't see why I didn't win that. I mean, their leader's not that good. Okay, good. Like, he's fine. I was gonna be a little peeved. But unfortunately, that is just the nature of the beast. And I'm sure I'm making mistakes. I'm playing at 5 a.m. I know some of you know that, but people that watch this in the future may not. It unfortunately does affect you negatively. Alright, now this guy's in a good place. We can't really assault him super easy. I mean, gotta say though, we've gone from being a tiny little place to a much bigger place, so we can't complain too much. I would love to get in another war soon, but we're already not in a great place. So their morale currently. What's your morale? Can I see it anywhere? Nope. It's, you know, a third. I mean, if 2.15 is their max. Like, we should be good. This will cross a river. I don't have any way around that. So we're already at a minus one. I don't know, boys. Oh, shit. I shouldn't have done it. Should have waited. That's okay. Like, we shouldn't lose this fight. Almost did, but we shouldn't. Excellent. Siege it up. Detach the mercenaries and go ahead and delete those guys. Cool. So now we've actually gone and... Was that painful? Yes, but we dealt with about 20 years of repressed rebellions. You know what I mean? Whereas to put down the rebels with brutal force option. There is actually that. Unfortunately, it costs military power to do it. And military power is pretty tricky to get, so I try not to do that. I forgot, actually, that we can manage our attitude here. Oh, no, you can't, not for allies. So we do have favors with them, so they owe us if we go to a war. Interesting. Okay. But yeah, I think we just spend a good amount of time here just trying to recover. I mean, this right here. Shit. Let's lower our army maintenance to zero again. No, I don't want to reduce inflation. That's fine. Okay, finally we got the loan repaid. Now we just work on rebuilding our force limit. Now the downside to vassalizing people, which actually we got a ton of free diplomats, may as well start improving relation over here. Again, we got to improve relation over here because I want to make sure these guys really like me. And Kalundwe. Yeah, I don't really have any. I need to break through this area. We do need to start this war, but unfortunately they are allied with these guys and these guys. So if any war happens, it's going to be big and it's going to be brutal. I don't think there's any way I can get a claim on those. Yeah, nothing I can do, sadly. Oh yeah, no, rebels in any game are a bane. This game, they're really nasty, though. Especially if you... Again, Paradox has done a lot to stop rapid expansion. But, we're gonna go ahead and mothball this guy. Put him in port over here. No, put him in port first. Okay. Meet up with the other ones, and then we'll mothball the whole... for them. Whoa, what is this? Clergy political struggle. Time has come for the clergy to appoint a new leader to assist our king in the capital. A likely candidate is an old cleric with a solid history as a prominent member of the clergy behind him. He has, however, acquired many enemies during his life, who now hope to see a somewhat younger candidate with a less ugly past be appointed. As king, it would not be hard to influence this election to a younger candidate who would likely be more loyal. To be seen to meddle in the affairs of the clergy, however, would likely weaken the faction in the long run. So we can lose money, lose prestige, gain loyalty, and lose influence. Or just gain some influence. Oh, shit. I don't really want them to gain influence, do I? There's already at 61%. Huh. There's no way to lower their influence, sadly. All right. Oh, that's fine then. So having them have a high influence, if they ever get up to 80% or higher, they can start making a play for the country itself, which is obviously a little scary. But hopefully we'll have military tech 3 soon. The enemy will not have military tech 3. Oh, they do. Oh, they've already beaten us there. Shit. So they're a lot stronger than we are, and they're stronger than our ally as well. I was hoping to beat them there. Okay, now we can have rivals. Lunda. Lunda's apparently the only rival we can have. I mean, I feel like these guys are a lot stronger, but sure. Whatever. If you want, if you say so, game. Alright, so we're almost there. Another 6 months and we'll be able to increase our military tech. And that's only because somebody else has done it first, thankfully. Stop them, or it's too expensive, lose some. Wow, for 10 years. Trade efficiency and national tax. Now let's go ahead and pay to stop that. That really hurts, but it's okay. You don't always get good events. In fact, normally you don't. Oh, we actually have another alliance slot. Getting someone like maybe Boohoo here. Or maybe Maravi. If we could convince this guy to ally with us, eventually we want his land. But for now, it would allow us to have someone that could run up here. Maybe get a little bit of a sneak attack. Start improving his relation and thinking about that. It's nice also to get into this area, but I'm not sure we're going to be able to. Not for a while, anyway. That place is just called Hee Hee. So funny, my friend. I like the way you make me laugh. Good jokes. I'll show them fight a large army with a small army. Well, no, actually, Origami, that's not going to work because their technology is higher. It's not anymore, thankfully. There we go. So they had much powerful, like more powerful troops than we did. So we finally just caught up. And they probably have a better leader, actually, in fact. Yeah, our son is still okay. His diplo tech is very high, so can't complain about that. I would like to have a better... You know what, actually... Let's go ahead and make our heir a general. He's pretty good, actually. He's pretty good. He's better than the guy we had, so... Oh, we're actually already above our naval force limit. Eh, it's not costing us that much. That's alright. We don't need these transport ships at all. I mean, I wouldn't mind getting rid of them. But... might use them at some point. I can't merge those, which is annoying. It's almost tempting to build some boats at this point, actually. Oh, we're actually already above our naval force limit. Eh, it's not costing us that much. That's alright. We don't need these transport ships at all. I mean, I wouldn't mind getting rid of them. But... might use them at some point, so... So this is the one downside to playing as Africa or something like that, is... things... it's just a little, little slow. You know, we can't really... keep going as fast as the European nations. But oh well. Alright, we need a little more manpower so I can go ahead and build our last spearman. Actually, how many cav do we have? We still got four? Yeah. Four is a nice number. Oh, yes! Administrative tech has finally gone up. Oh, just amazing. We really need to get this to 5 so we can start doing things. Because at 5, you're allowed to get your first national idea. Ours is going to be exploration, which is really, really important for us to get anywhere into... rest of Africa. I mean, right now, though, you could argue, well, we can't do anything right... oh, shit. I'm gonna spend money to not lose stability, yeah. Like, unfortunately, right now, we can't take advantage of having exploration, but we still need it. You know what I mean? It's gonna take us a long time to do it. To take advantage of it, we need to basically secure the majority of this basin. And then start... dipping out into this direction. Are you willing to be my friend now? Occupied by... oh, Killa is going to take them over. Shit. That's fair. I mean, I would if I was Killa. Killa is certainly very powerful. I hope they don't. Anyway, we got an alliance out of it anyway. We'll see how long they last. Yeah, they're gonna lose this war. The question is how much did they lose, you know what I mean? I imagine... oh, everything. Oh, wow. I mean, what the fuck? That's a pretty shitty alliance there. I'm gonna decline that, pal. Yeah. Gonna have to break our alliance there. Do our other allies get pissed off? Apparently they don't care. They don't even know who he is. Do we ally with Mutapa then? Again, I'm gonna want his territory eventually. But having him in the war against these guys would be pretty good. I'm not sure if he'll bother to come up here or not. I don't know. Maybe we go for someone a lot simpler, like Buha. He doesn't have Tech 3 yet. Hopefully our ally gets Military Tech 3 so they have a chance. Chokwe even has 3. I don't understand that exactly. And there's no way that you would ally me. Sadly. Luba, who are you allied with? Linda. Oh, you're allied with our ally. What a derp shit. You're Tech 3, though. What do you say, pal? You and I are going to start being friends. Alright? I don't need allies? Oh, I do. We've had a lot of painful losses. We'll just say that much. Things are on a very slow road to recovery. So. I think that we'll grab this guy as a pal. But hey, Robopox, how you doing, man? If I could get him, I'd feel pretty safe about doing my war. Let's see. Gain extra manpower. Nagango gains liberty desire, and they like us less. Or lose prestige. I mean, I need that manpower. Liberty desire means they're less likely to be annexed by me. Yeah, that's okay. Tyrant Overlord. Well, I guess. You and I are going to be friends. Mouse hovers over build spy network button. I thought about it. Not going to lie. Things were thought. This is going to be like a massive world war when it eventually does take place, though. Okay, let's go ahead and jack up military stuff. Alright. So is that your whole army, then? Can't be right. Kalindwe. Yeah, no, it is. I mean, they got a ton of manpower, though, so they can lose people, and it won't matter too much. Do we get our Diplotech up? I mean, we don't really need the points right now, but we will if we go to war. Yeah, we'll hang on to it, sadly. What's our maximum for that? Tons. Okay. I really want to do it. What's going on here? Chokwe. Are you at war? Just with Kikanja. Except Chokwe's coming. Oh yeah, Chokwe's your ally. What? No, they're not. What's going on here? They ask for military access or something? And you're just fighting this? Everybody apparently declared war on this guy? Random. If I declared war, would you come in if I gave you territory? No, but everybody else would. and Linda. Linda, why are you allied with these guys? When did that happen? What the fuck? Oh, leave it to my only ally to be allied with everybody I hate. Huh. Well, anyway, I'm going to go ahead, we'll lower our army maintenance then. Doesn't look like anything's going to happen right now, which is fine. And I'm going to save it and call it for the night, sadly. It's 5:40 a.m. I should have gone to bed earlier, but yeah, whatever. Things happen. Things are going okay for Congo. Not too bad. Not too good. I'm sort of at a crossroads here. I want to expand, but last time we expanded too fast and we dealt with, you know, a 10-year stall and everything because of rebellion. And that was okay. That was my fault. I made a few mistakes. I'm tired. But, so right now, these four, sort of the major powers here, are all in an alliance. Not really sure my plan. You know? Unfortunately, I don't have the ability to get to this guy to declare claims on him. You know? Hard to say. Will you take an alliance right now? You will. Well, I got Buha on my side. And that's something. That is something. I think we just start a massive world war. I'm not sure how we do that. And I'm not sure the smart way to do it. If I was to declare war on this guy. Hang on, let me see what happens here. Just want to see who would join me. Neither of these guys would. Which is... because right now they're fighting a war at the same side, yeah. Okay, I was gonna say, this guy owes me 10 favors, though. And right now, only Kazembe would join in this war, actually. Maybe we do a snatch grab on... yeah, that's how it's been all game, though, Robopox. These guys, it was actually these two and this guy allied. We took him out, thankfully. Sometimes the game does that to you, though. So, the trick... now, I mean, right now he's in a war on the same side. I understand that. I understand that. Oh, I actually don't have any way to forge a claim on them either. So, maybe I... I mean, I almost might have to break this alliance here. I really wanted to be friends, but... anyway, that's for next time, guys. A lot to think about. A lot going on. Because right now our expansion is completely halted by this. For sure, we need to take this territory so I can get this territory. So I can get this territory. I mean, if I could take both these. Grab this because I need this so I can get over onto this whole section. And that's as far as I can get without being able to colonize this. Once I colonize Rukwa, I'm able to start munching into Eastern Africa and Southern Eastern Africa and all the cool stuff there. But, yeah, things are a bit crazy, so we'll see. We'll see. Anyway, have a nice night, guys, and I will see you tomorrow, as always.